beginning my studies, the first step pleased me so much, the mere fact consciousness. These forms, the pattern of motion, the least insect or animal,
ship. Thank you. just a moment, I'd like to reflect on Jesus' account of the Last Judgment as we find it in Matthew chapter 25. That famous passage about the king in all his glory separating people the way a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. I don't have many sheep and goats memories, having grown up in suburbia, but I do recall a trip to a petting zoo, and what I recall from that was that the sheep, especially the lambs, were absolutely adorable, cuddly, and great to be around. And that while the goats initially, especially the kids, were cute and frisky, they seemed to spend an awful lot of time butting heads and biting. Not exactly the best thing for a petting zoo. So when Jesus talks about separating the sheep and the goats, I'm kind of with him already in the sheep department rather than in the goat department. I suppose there are artist illustrations that show very literally the separation of sheep and goats, but the most famous artist illustration of this particular teaching is found in Rome in the Sistine Chapel behind the altar. And it takes up the entire wall. It's a fresco that was completed by Michelangelo in 1541. And as we look at that, whether in person or in illustrations, what we see is Jesus in his glory, a central figure, and we see on the one hand those he is commending on their way to their heavenly reward, and then we see those he is not commending on their way to eternal punishment. I've come across people down through the ages who would like to believe in the idea of universal salvation. So as a corrective to that, we have what Michelangelo painted, which seems much more accurate and in relation to what Jesus taught. I also like the name of Michelangelo's painting in Italian because it means universal judgment, not last judgment. Of course, the judgment is of how we have conducted our lives. And the meter for that is both high and holy and also simple and humble. The simple and humble part is how have we treated our fellow human beings? Kindness, compassion, caring, really seeing them and really seeing their need and doing something about it, not necessarily heroic, but something that means all the difference in the world to them. And then finding out, surprisingly, that when we've done it to the least of these, we've done it to Christ our Lord. May it be so for all of us.
Jesus, the very thought of thee with sweetness fills my breast. But sweet of heart thy face to see, and in thy presence rest. Nor voice can sing, nor heart can frame, nor can the memory find. Sweet. sound than thy blessed name, O Savior of mankind. O hope of every contrite heart, O joy of all the meek, to those who fall, how kind thou art, how good to those who seek. Jesus, what it is, none but his loved ones know. As thou art.